This is the specific solution that I can provide in a relationship. Niche, ideal client, and target audience. These three are not the same. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel, the best place for new coaches, content creators, and entrepreneurs. In today's video, we are in my office, more of a casual vlog style video today, but I really want to tackle the question of how to find a niche. And to be honest with you, if you are just a content creator, you really don't need to find a niche right away. I know even for me in my first year, I was stressing out so much about finding a niche, and I know it consumes a lot of people, but I'm going to tell you right now, if I were to be really honest, when I started my content creation journey, here on YouTube or even on Instagram, I really didn't have a niche, and that's okay. And so in this video, I really want to talk to you guys about why it's not that important to find a niche right away, how to eventually find the niche, and what to do in the meantime. Now, before we dive into talking all things niche and all that stuff, I want to let you know that I have an ebook right here that outlines the top 50 lessons that I learned in my first year of business. This is a full jam-packed 50-page PDF with all the mistakes and lessons that I learned in my first year of business. And for those who don't know me, maybe it's your first time watching my videos, I went from zero to $500,000 in my first year, and now heading into my second year and third year, we're now a multiple seven-figure business. So I highly recommend that you click the link in the comment section or in the description box below to snag this ebook. With that out of the way, let's talk about the whole discussion about finding a niche. All right, so let's talk about this whole niche thing. And I put my camera on my desk because I was getting tired of holding it, but there are three things that people need to understand the difference between, and that is niche, ideal client, and target audience. These three are not the same, and you really need to understand the definitions of each. So let's go through them one by one, and then afterwards, I'll walk you through exactly what you need to start with in order to get closer to finding your niche or just getting started when it comes to creating content on YouTube, Instagram, doesn't really matter. So the first thing that we want to talk about is niche. And what a niche is basically a specific solution that you provide to a specific person. It is very, very specific and very similar to what I teach in my own program to my own students inside the Bossgram Academy. I explain it as a niche really isn't an industry and it isn't a category. So if you say that your niche is within fitness, that's technically not true. Fitness is really an industry. It's not a niche. Whereas if you say I help moms overcome post-baby weight while they're still working a 9-to-5 job, that is a niche. That is very specific in terms of what you do, who you help, and the problem that you solve. Now that you've understood the niche, let's talk about the next definition, and that is your ideal client. An ideal client is someone who's ultra specific. You could literally put a name on this person. You could name the hair color that they have. You could name the problems that they're facing. You could name literally all the objections that they have, every single specific thing about this person. And that is your ideal client. It is basically the specific person who would be a perfect fit for your products and services. Then afterwards, the next definition that we have is target audience. Now you are getting less specific. You are talking about a group of people that share similar psychographics and similar demographics that could still be a good fit for your services, but it's not really specific. Now, if you still don't really understand the differences between these three, something that I like to do is using a dating analogy. So let's say I am on Bumble or I'm on Tinder or I'm on Hinge. My target audience is literally going to be the demographics that I'm going to be setting in my dating preferences. I'm going to say that I'm looking for men ages between 21 to 25, let's say, who are interested in sports, who are at least, you know, 5'7" and have all these different qualities. That is my target audience. That is the person that I'm trying to target on this dating app. Then afterwards, my ideal client, that is my dream man. That is the person that I am dreaming about at night. I'm literally sleeping and I can envision all the specifics of this dream man that I want to attract. So for example, your specific customer or your specific dream man could be Brad. Brad is a cat lover, family man, goes to church every Sunday. He loves to watch Breaking Bad on Netflix, and he's really great at making delicious chicken wings. He's a senior partner at his accounting firm, but he's not so great at keeping track of his finances. Here, when you're talking about your ideal client or customer, it's really specific. You could literally paint a picture of who is your ideal dream partner. Then afterwards, my niche, this is the specific solution that I can provide in a relationship, let's say. So let's say I'm a really great accountant. I'm super good with numbers. That basically means that whoever fits the ideal profile of the man that I'm looking for, I've got them covered. I'm going to be able to take care of all of the finances in the household. That is the specific solution that I can provide and bring to this relationship. Now, obviously, this dating analogy isn't necessarily perfect, but I hope it gives you a really clear visual or a clear analogy on the differences between your target audience, your ideal client, and your niche. Now that you know the differences between the three, the next question that you might have is, okay, great, I know the differences, but what do I do now? Now, let me actually share with you my journey when I started on YouTube. I actually didn't have a niche. I didn't have a specific solution to a specific problem. If you look back in the archives, I was kind of all over the place, but it still worked for me. It still made sense. Why is that? Well, that's because when I first started out, I didn't focus on finding a niche. Instead, I focused on catering my content to a target audience. And my target audience was basically millennials, anyone between the ages of 21 to 25 who are in their first or second year of their corporate job and they're realizing that they don't like it. It's really broad. This person also has college experience or is university educated and all those things. When I started focusing on just catering content to a target audience, it allowed me to be a little bit more creative in my content. It allowed me to really test different topics on my YouTube channel. So for instance, when I'm focusing on the target audience of millennials, I'm able to post content like social media. I'm able to post content about finances, about post-graduation, about career. I'm still really broad, but it still works for me and I'm still able to grow a solid subscriber base because I'm still within the target audience. Now, thankfully, because I focused on being a little bit broader, I was able to experiment. And because I experimented, I was able to find my sweet spot eventually. And that's when I realized that my social media videos were taking off. And the moment that I noticed this, I niched down. I started to be a little bit more focused. Not only was I just talking about any social media platform, I was specifically talking about Instagram. And as the years and months went on, I became even more specific. I'm now really creating content for new coaches and content creators specifically. So as you can see, when I started my journey, I wasn't necessarily just doing a specific niche. I started with a target audience, and then eventually I started to narrow down even more as I got more experience with creating content, finding what works, and finding out what I like to do as well. That's why if you are someone who is struggling to find your niche, but you also don't want to be all over the place in your content, focus on creating content for your target audience instead, and over time, just narrow it down. I promise over time, you're gonna get crystal clear on what your niche is really gonna be. Now, obviously, this advice works really well if you're just a content creator and you're doing this to maybe grow an audience, to grow your social media platform, and you're not necessarily diving into a business yet. However, if you are someone who's watching this video and you're interested in starting a business, in selling a product or service, that's when my advice is gonna be a little bit different. Okay. That's when it's really important to find a niche because your product and service literally needs to speak to a specific person and solve a specific problem, especially if you want to succeed amongst the competition. And so that's why my advice right here in the video is very specific and catered to content creators. Whereas my niching down advice in my program, the Bossgram Academy, that's where I go in depth in terms of how to find a profitable niche, especially for business owners and coaches. Now, if you want a taste of more information of finding a niche, definitely check out my free training at www.followerstoclients.com. I talk a little bit more about finding a niche. And on top of that, I give you two more free trainings as well when it comes to creating content and also creating your first social media funnel on Instagram. So definitely check out the comment section or the description box below in order to access this free training. But anyways, guys, this is a short and sweet video. And I really hope that by sharing the three definitions that you need to understand between niche, target audience, and ideal client, that you're able to get massive clarity on how to take the next steps in your content creation journey. Because remember, it's not worth stressing so much about finding a niche, especially when you're just starting out. You really don't know what you like yet. You don't know what's gonna stick. And so again, instead of focusing all your energy on finding a specific niche, just focus on creating content for a target audience instead. Over time, you'll then be able to narrow down who your ideal client is, who you really want to create content for, and then afterwards, you're going to be able to monetize and find a niche so that you can create products and services to sell to this ideal client or ideal customer. Now, if you really like the tip that I gave you today, make sure you also download my ebook. Again, this ebook has 50 more lessons that I learned in my first year of business. So check out the link in the description box or in the comment section below to snag this ebook. Now, while you wait for next week's video, I post a lot of videos on content creation, social media, entrepreneurship, coaching, and all the likes of that. So make sure you check out these two videos that I have here as well. As always, guys, I appreciate you. I hope you guys have a great day, a great week, and a great life, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.